you are here, and you said you'd never leave. We need you, Lord. We need you, Lord. You are here, and you said you'd never leave. We need you, Lord. 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 And you said you'd never leave. We need you, Lord. We need you, Lord.
We need you, Lord.
You are here.
You are here.
And you said,
and you said you'd never leave.
We need you, Lord.
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 Jesu namhlanje kuseni kuyintokozo enkulu ukuba sishumayele izwi laNkulunkulu kinina namhlanje. Siyabonga uNkulunkulu that who gave us strength, who protected us up until this point. This is Pastor Sahluko, a lead pastor for Discovery Church. So I just want to share the word of the Lord with you this morning. uNkulunkulu alibekile enhlizweni yami. I just want to speak about faith. I'm not talking about faith where we in a reference of a religion ukuthi ukholo kwakho kuyini. So I just want to speak about faith as an evidence as what uNkulunkulu akushile ezweni lakhe ukuthi ukholwa kuyisiqinisekiso kuthina nokuthi ukholwa olungileyo uyophila ngakho. I just want to read this verse kanye nawe kafushane litholakala ku Romans 1. I will read only over 17. Uthi for in it the righteousness of God is revealed. From faith for faith. That's what I love. From faith for faith. As it is written, the righteous shall live by faith. Olungileyo uyophila ngokukholwa. It's so exciting, bazalwane. Ngathi uNkulunkulu, he knew, he foresee ukuthi there will be times like this. There will be times that will be so challenging, that will be so confusing. The times that will make you ukuthi kwesinye isikhathi mhlawumbe ungazazi ukuthi umiphi, uyaphambili noma uyemuva, you are confused. Everything, it's like it's against you. The world, everything that is happening around you, there is nothing that is exciting. There is nothing that is bringing hope to you. But the Bible comes and declares and say the righteous shall live by faith. So which means olungileyo akaphili by affordability, akaphili by what government says, akaphili about what does the environment says about him, but the righteous shall live by faith. Hallelujah. So if the righteous is living by faith, which means now ukholwa kwethu kuyini. But that's where I want to start namhlanje. I want to tell you that our faith is our reality. Ukholo kwethu kithina, we don't, it doesn't become as something that esiplaka in kuyona when it's difficult times. We don't plug into faith when we want to achieve something. We don't plug into faith if we want to receive something from the Lord. But I want to tell you that our daily life needs faith. So our lifestyle needs faith. Faith isiphila ngayo. Everything esiyenzayo siyenza ngokholo, because olungileyo uyakuphila ngokholo. I want you to understand that faith is our reality. So Tina, we don't live by what we see. We don't live by circumstances. We don't live about how we feel. Sometimes when we wake up in the morning, we don't feel like doing certain things. Sometimes even us, even as pastors, when we want to preach, sometimes we don't feel like preaching. But I want to tell you that we do it by faith, because we know what faith, it is our reality. So I want you to understand what the things that are about uyoba nokukholwa ngakho ukuze uyireceive, bese kuba ngathi they will become a reality when we have received them. I want to tell you that our things, they become a reality in non-existence in your own eyes. So whenever ungakazi uyibone ngamehlo, but I want to tell you that once it's within your spirit and then you begin to declare, you begin to speak about it, then you begin to tap in where it is originally. Because even if uNkulunkulu ezokhanda umuntu, lithi Bible, what must senza umuntu ngomfanekiso wakhe, before he created or before abumba umuntu, he had umuntu engqondweni yakhe. So uthe uma ngabe umuntu esebunjwa, umuntu eseqale ebonakala emhlabeni, it was the reflection of the reality that kade kuNkulunkulu. So I want you to know ukuthi the faith that you have in God, it becomes your reality. So the things that you haven't touched, the things that you haven't seen, the things that ungakazi uyinyathele kuzona, I want to tell you that they become your reality. Because olungileyo uyakuphila ngokukholwa. We don't live under circumstances, but we live over circumstances. Ingakho lithi iBhayibheli uSathane ungaphansi kwenyawo zethu. Because we live over him, we walk in authority, we walk in dominion, because God is our strength, God is our pillar. So I want you to have that in mind, that your faith is your reality. So njengamanje, then there's something that is happening in the country. People then kwenzekile abanye, then they were looting things, they were taking things, and then, but what is happening? The government sent cops. Ithumela amaphoyisa ukuthi amaphoyisa wahamba oyilanda. The only thing that was needed to prove ukuthi leyo nto leyo ingeyakho, it was the receipt. Oh, praise the Lord. The Bible, when you read Hebrews chapter 11 verse 1 wakhona, lithi ukholwa kuqiniseka kwezinto ezingabonwayo nezethenjwayo. But the English version says, it says faith, it is the receipt of the things that are unseen. I want to tell you that the receipt becomes the reality, becomes the proof that what you have, it is yours. I want you to understand that when you have faith, then you are able to access things that are not seen. You are able to access things that are not touched. You are able to access things that people, other people, they haven't seen. But when you apply it by faith, and then you begin to speak by faith, you begin to declare, and things begin to manifest in your spirit, and then they begin to manifest in your reality. Because faith, it is an assurance. Faith, it is a sleep. So faith, it is the reality in your mind, in your heart. When you begin to speak what you believe in, and then it becomes a reality. Uma ngabe isiqala yenzeka, isuka abantu sebeyibona kuwena, isuka isikade yenzeka. I remember one of the greatest guy that would design a Disney World. So bathi abantu mangabe beyivula Disney World, bembuza bethi uzizwa unjani ubona yonke lento. UDisney washo one thing, this guy eya design Disney World, yathi what I see, what enikubonayo today nina, kade ngakubona mina. So it's not something yena aqala ukuyibona ngoba isi materializer, but it's something that ayibona before it manifests. Because faith was an assurance, the just shall live by faith. So I want you to understand what you've been praying for, you need to begin to live by that. So what you've been asking God for, you must believe ukuthi now I have received it, and ngiyaqala ngiyaphila khona. You begin to walk like that, you begin to speak like that, you begin to act like that, you begin to move the environment, you begin to clean up, you begin to sort out things. Why? Because you are believing ukuthi what wena usukhulumile, it shall manifest. Because that's what the word of the Lord and this thing is called faith. It's our lifestyle, it's what we live, it's what we live. I've said that faith, we don't tap into it, but it becomes our lifestyle. We speak it in the morning. That's why I go to Abraham, little Bible, unkulunkulu wambiza. Mbizo Abraham, Abraham, he never saw the world or the land that unkulunkulu ayimbizele lona. But lithi iBhayibheli wathi phuma ehlobeni zakini, phuma kubangani bakho, phuma to your comfortable environment, phuma to an environment, the setup that oyijwayele, the setup that you think it's fine for you, the setup that what uyibona ikusebenzela for years. Unkulunkulu wathi come, and I want you to tap into an environment that you never seen. I want you to come to an environment that you never experienced. And lithi iBhayibheli, what the eyes hasn't seen, what the ears angakaza kuzwe about what the Lord is about to do in our lives. I want you to understand that there is a season that we are tapping in. There is a season that we are moving in as a church. There is a platform. There is a dimension that we are entering as a church that uNkulunkulu asibeka kuyona. But it will only be tapped in through faith. Those that they have faith in God, and then they will begin to manifest. They will begin to see these things, because ukholwa kuza ngokuzwa izwi. So the word of God, if you hear through the word of the Lord, then you become, then what God has spoken, it becomes a reality to you. I want to remind you that the Bible says there was a man, and it's Bible, wakunendlala on that land, on that particular land. Ngendlela kwasekuyiyona, lithi iBhayibheli basibedla umswane wamajuba, bedla everything engasabonakali utho. Everyone was even isima sasesiyisona. Lithi iBhayibheli omunye wayesethi mina the situation was bad. It was more than the economic crisis. Everything was down. Everything was bad. There was no hope. There was no future. But the word of the Lord began to speak. Praise be the Lord. The word of the Lord begin to speak. Lithi Bible wathi mayikhuluma umprofeti kaNkulunkulu wathi kusasa impuphu nakho konke kuyobe kuyinala at the gate. And the Bible says definitely on the following day when they walk out begijima begeithini there was inala. But lithi Bible there was a man who didn't believe the word of the prophet. There was a man who said no, even isha ngabe kuthiwa amazulu avulekile lento ngeke yenzeke. I want to tell you that what the Lord has spoken of our lives, what the Lord has spoken in my life, then what the Lord has spoken in your life, in your family, about you, about the environment, I want to tell you that if you believe in it, you will begin to walk in it. But those that they don't believe in it, lithi Bible bagijima bahamba phezu kwakhe wafa, he saw it but he never experienced it. I want you to understand that when you begin to believe in the word of the Lord, then you will begin to manifest, to walk on the promises of God, because the promises of God are yes and amen. Amen. What the Lord has promised, it shall come to pass. I want you to declare this morning that you are who God says you are. You have what God says you have. You are able to do exceedingly and abundantly. You are not limited by age, by number, by the environment, but you are walking with what is within you. The Lord, that if you understand who you are and you understand what the Lord has done in your life and what the Lord has impacted in your life, you are able to walk through. That's why I want you to understand. I want you to forth in Amhlanje Kuseni. I want you not to be limited by the environment. I want you to begin to speak. Speak against that sickness. Speak against that depression. Speak against that limitation of life. Speak against anything that is limiting you. If you are ufuna lo msebenzi, begin to speak. Ukuthi Nkosi, I receive it. I thank you for this job. And then you begin to thank God for the environment. You begin to set out the environment. You begin to set out the situation. Ukuthi I am ready for this. I came to declare this morning that sometimes when you are praying for the car, begin to open up a gate. Don't limit God. You are praying for a car. Begin to prepare for the blessing that you are expecting. Begin to walk in your expectation. Someone that was on an expectation, when God begins to work, that person, he is ready for what the Lord is about to do. I want you to understand, Mtakababa, as we pray this morning, that faith, it is the assurance. Faith, it is our reality. Faith, it is our lifestyle. Faith, it is our evidence. Faith, ukukholwa esinakho kuyiforce for the product, for the end product. I want you to understand that good by faith, little Abraham, what noma sebamdala umntwana azi ukuthi akamtholi, kodwa because of the word of the Lord, little kholwa kwakhe akuzange kwehle, kwakhula kanye naye. Why? Because faith, it is the force for the end product. Then ukholwa khona kwampusha, kwamdrive towards the end, towards the promise of the Lord. There is a promise that God has spoken over your life. I want you to take it, I want you to grab it, I want you to believe it, because it is your time, it is your season, it is your moment. I came to declare this morning that there is greatness in you, there is anointing in you, there is a blessing in you. You are born for this, you are destined for greatness, you are wonderfully made and fearfully made. Lifestyle, faith, it is your lifestyle. I need you to grab it. I want you to believe it. I want you to take it. I want you to speak it. Because when you begin to speak the word of the Lord over your life, over your sickness, you know, call it a pipe. We don't pray for victory, but we pray from victory. I want you to understand this morning that faith, then I am healed. By faith, everything that I wanted, it has been delivered, because God, he is the answer. Faith is our reality. I want you to know that faith is our evidence. Faith is our lifestyle. Everything revolves around faith. Begin to speak. God has given you the word. When you begin to speak the word of the Lord in your life, and then you will begin to see the change. This morning, I just want to pray with you, because there's something supernatural that will begin to take place in the next few days, in the next month. God is about to do something. Then the shifting, there's a shifting that is happening in the atmosphere. I declare that the environment is conducive for miracles to occur. The environment is beginning to opening up for what the Lord is about to do in your life. God will do something amazing. God will do something great in your life. There is something supernatural that is beginning to take place in your family, in your environment, in your workplace, in your friends, in your setup. Your setup is being blessed. Your setup is being anointed. Your environment is being anointed by the grace of the Lord. Favor upon your life. Then it will begin to open doors wherever you walk, wherever you go. Then faith will begin to walk in front of you. I wanted to tell you that people, they will be waiting for you because of this favor. Go out and be ready for the manifestation of God, because God is doing something supernatural in your life. We bless you tonight. We bless you this morning by the name of Jesus Christ. I want you to understand that in faith, it is our lifestyle. God bless you.